We're not in it yet. So anyway, welcome everyone. Hello, I'm Adam Phillips. Welcome to Paul's Crossroads Ceremony. Before we begin the bell that will begin our event, I ask everyone to shut off their cell phones, their beepers, their monkey minds, just show up. All that's got to do is just be here and take a moment. Before we actually begin the ceremony prep, I really want to thank Charlotte, the Celebrate Foundation, and Pat, and everybody who made this day possible, including people helping with refreshments, help clean this place up and spruce it up and everything, and thank you so much. And this is wonderful that all these things came together for us to be here tonight and really have a wonderful experience. I think it was like going down the rabbit hole. This is what we're all going to do together, okay? We're all going to like hold hands and just have an adventure, okay? It's going to be the focus. It's going to be the man. So it's a moment to appreciate and just have fun. Okay? So we're going to start. I'm going to do the bell.
A little louder.
Can you hear me?
A little louder.
All right, I'll try to project. Okay. I may lapse into my normal FM late night voice, but I'll try. So this is the thing that gets us there. So just take a deep breath, get comfortable. Beautiful, right? We're here tonight to acknowledge and to celebrate the crossroads where Paul Wax finds himself. In doing so, we gather to witness in microcosm the journey that has brought Paul to this place, and we support him as he chooses a new life path as a man, as a provider, and as a productive, creative, and self-expressed citizen of this community and the larger world. What we're here for. Honoring the past, being clear and straight about what is so in the present, and declaring a future is what tonight is all about for Paul and for those who care about him and are connected to him in any way. I ask Paul to please light this candle for us as a symbol of that intention.
I'm delighted to do this.
Attention, Kim.
It's okay.
Love your life. On one level, this ceremony is about a man and his work. And on another level, it's also about what work itself is. I've always wanted to be able to quote Elizabeth the Queen Mother at one of my ceremonies, so I finally got my chance. She said, "Work is the rent you pay for the room you occupy on earth." We all know what that means. Work is a part of every meaningful life. It connects us to the world each day and gives us a place to go. It puts bread on the table and allows us to nourish ourselves and our loved ones. Our work also benefits others. It puts bread or something else that they value on their tables. So much of what we offer is our work, because it's what we do. And as such, it's intimately tied up with who we believe ourselves to be. Our labors give us a place in this world. After talking to Paul's many friends and admiring colleagues over the past several weeks, it's clear to me that Paul has worked hard and well his whole life and given himself over to every task he's had. He grew up in the Brooklyn and Jersey City, but mainly Jersey City, of the 50s and 60s, learning the guitar and working in the supermarket, through his first adult jobs as a bond processor at Manufacturers Hanover's, then as a junior data processor, and that gave him his first exposure to information technology, which I'm just beginning to sort of understand is really interesting. We were at war in Vietnam, and soon Paul was drafted to the Army, where he was trained as a telecommunications encryption code specialist, and served in Thailand, South Vietnam, Laos, and Cambodia. After his discharge, Paul returned to work in early corporate computing and went on to marry and become a father to three girls, beautiful girls, while attending evening classes for 14 years to attain his degree by the age of 36. His development work with the pioneers in virtual college distance learning at NYU during the 1980s is still being used today. All in all, Paul's career has been a steady progression toward greater responsibility and mastery in his work for others. Throughout it, Paul has brought intelligence, solid character, and good humored fun in all his endeavors. And I'll just sort of say, parenthetically, I talk to a lot of people about Paul all over the country. And this isn't just fluff, this isn't like a nice thing to say. He really did testify to his competence, his intelligence, his good humored fun, and his character. People really admire and love this guy, okay? So like, that's who we're dealing with.
I paid him later.
See? Paid him in euros, basically. Yet in spite of all his good faith and success, Paul was suddenly downsized last December at the height of his power. Not an easy moment at 61. 61 years into a long life, which, suffice it to say, has not always been easy. Yet Paul is crystal clear that each of these major challenges in his life has also brought him to new heights. And each phase of his life has offered its own hard-earned lesson as a gift. The meaning of that lesson may sometimes have been unclear or even unknowable to Paul at the time. But it was always there for him to rely on down the road, a gem he could integrate into the next phase of his life.
Louder.
And finding that gem, I took the paragraph again, it's really important. The meaning of that lesson may sometimes have been unclear or even unknowable to Paul at the time. Yet it was always there for Paul to rely on down the road, a gem that he could integrate into the next phase of his career in life. Finding that gem, polishing it, bringing out its true color and luster, then putting it to work for the good of ourselves and for others, is the work inside the work. To paraphrase Paul, there are no accidents. The poet T.S. Eliot said, in part, "You shall not cease from exploration, and the end of all our exploring will be to arrive where we started, and to know the place for the first time. Not known, because not looked for, but heard, half heard, in the stillness between the two waves of the sea." From the stillness and care that we are creating here, let us witness what those waves of Paul's life's labors have been so far, and what are the gifts that they have laid upon the shore. Please open up the first book. Tell us what is inside and what its gift is.
Well, this is the beginning of my life. And I have some symbols, artifacts, etc.